But people don't understand this verse. People don't understand this verse.
The vine and the branches. I am the true vine, and my Father is the gardener. He cuts off every branch in me that bears no fruit, while every branch that does not bear fruit, he prunes so that it will be even more fruitful.
Amen.
Today Jesus Christ says he is the tree. He is the tree. He's not just any tree, he's a true vine. Not the usual vein, but the true vein. He is a true vein. He's not just a tree, it's just not a tree, it's a true vein. And he says this tree is being bred, is being planted by God. He says God is the one who planted this tree. I'm not the one who planted, but not, and you're not even you. Hallelujah. We will forget to water the tree. We will forget. But God won't forget. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He is the tree. The planter of this tree. He is the Father. You are the branches. God expects something from you. Hallelujah. Amen. Don't tend to be a branch. A branch does not bear fruit. God says that the branch that does not bear fruit, he's going to cut it. Hallelujah. It's painful to be cut by God.
That's why you tell me to move on Mark chapter 11, if we learn to
pray. Hallelujah.
Mark chapter 11, verse 12.
Hallelujah. Jesus cursed the tree.
Why?
Because he was hungry. Looking for something from the tree. But when he arrived there, he found nothing. Jesus cursed the tree. Hallelujah. Where God has abandoned no one, hallelujah. No one, hallelujah, can unbind. If God curses you, hallelujah. It's so, settles you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Genesis chapter 43.
Mark chapter 11, verse 12.
It reads, the next day as they were leaving, Bethany, Jesus was hungry, seeing in the distance a fig tree in leaf, he went to find out if it had any fruit. When he reached it, he found nothing but leaves, because it was not the season for figs. 14. Then he said to the tree, May no one ever eat fruit from you again. And his disciples heard him say it. 15. On reaching Jerusalem, Jesus entered the temple.
A ba swere ke tala a bona setlhare sa mogo se le gojana se teteane a ya ka gore motho mongwe a ka hwetsa o na le selo a fitla a hwetsa o sene selo ge e se makala ka gobane e be e se lebaka la mago. Jesu a bolela le setlhare seo sa mogo a re go ka se thwe go ija motho se enywa sa gago le neng le neng. Barutua ba gagwe ba mokwane a riyane. Amen. Jesus o bona setlhare sa mogo.
Jesus saw a tree.
O expecta something mo setlhareng.
He expects something from this tree. When he arrived there, he found branches.
O be a tshwere ke tlala.
He was hungry. That means when God brought us to this world, he expects something from us. There's a day when he will be hungry. There is a certain day where he will look for something from you. Hallelujah. But if you don't praise him the way it must be, the Bible says he will cut you off. The Bible says he will cut you off. Hallelujah. 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 True fruits. He is sure. Hallelujah. That the fruits that will come from you. Hallelujah. So eat your fruits. Don't. Hallelujah. He will cut you off. Jesus says the tree that the branch that does not bear fruits, he is going to cut it off. If the branch that bears fruits, you will hallelujah, make it to increase. If you bear fruits, hallelujah. Don't be surprised when blessings come your way. He says the hallelujah. Your life will be filled with blessings. Because that any time when he looks for you, he found you. When he wants you to praise him, he finds you. If he wants you to pray for someone, he finds you. If you want to hallelujah, he finds you. The Bible says, hallelujah, you bear fruits. And you bear more and more fruits. Don't be surprised if you bear many fruits. The one who sent you, hallelujah. The same one who planted you. He's the same one who will let you increase, your fruits increase. And God, he expects fruit from you no matter what the situation is. Hallelujah. He's not looking for any excuse. Hallelujah. He doesn't look for any excuse. You are, no matter the rain is there, no matter how hot is the fire, if he sent you, he wants you to go there. No matter how the tough is the situation, God expects fruit from you. There's no a parent who will bring a child on earth and doesn't expect anything from you. Let me tell you, if you are here, our parents are looking for something from us. What about God? What do you give God? As you can, hallelujah, satisfy your parents. As you can say thank you to your parents. What about God? What do you give to God? Can you say thank you to God? Can you say thank you to Jesus? You planted me. You're in these two veins. Here are the branches of God. Here are the fruits of the fruit of God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Let's go forward and say, God, here are your fruits. Let not be jealous. Hallelujah. Let not be jealous for God. And say, God, you gave us, but you want us to give you back to you. Let's praise God. Let's go and give him those fruits.
Hallelujah.
Amen. God expects fruit from us. No matter what the situation, God expects.